City of Glasgow Pipe Band, led by Pipe Major Hugh McGinns. We're just awaiting the arrival of Lord Litchfield, who's just come through the gate. Dysart and Dundonald. Thank you.
Thank you. shouting, you can hear him, eh? Tell him he's shouting.
Dysart and Dundonald, led by Pipe Major George Shepherd, They will be playing for about 15, 20 minutes. We will then have City of Glasgow back, and then there will be a break. Ladies and gentlemen, Dysart and Dundonald. Thank you. Thank you, Dysart and Dundonald. In a few moments, we will have the City of Glasgow pipe band back in again. I think they're still trying to tune up.
No, it's not, I'm struggling for light.
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the City of Glasgow Pipe Band.
All the lads in the band, all the lads in the band love you now.
Yeah. Hey, well, we're all sleeping back in our quality. Oh, anyway.
See in the background, the bongo drums are coming out. The traditional type of piping is finished, and Dysart are going to show you something with a little bit of a difference. I think they're going to do something like Ian Moore of Wolverhampton does. After Dysart has played, there will be an interval for about 25 minutes. And we will have, tonight, with his guitar, James Stewart, who's a solo piper, giving us a little strum on his guitar and a song. And if he sings like he plays, we'll just go to the bar. The selection that Dysart are going to play was going to be the finale for the evening, but because Lord Lichfield and Lady Elizabeth got to go to a dining evening, they're going to do this a little bit earlier so they can hear before they go. Ladies and gentlemen, Dysart and Dundonald.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, to dance together, Patrick and Dundonald. Well, they said they'd do something a little bit different. Oh, we've got something even more different. Jimmy Stewart, a solo piper, tonight is going to make his debut playing the guitar and sing. Right? I've no idea what it's going to sound like. I'll just go and fetch him. Ladies and gentlemen, Jimmy Stewart. I've been told to keep it clean. I've never done what I've been told. I was dropped into this last night by Bill Ferguson. It wasn't meant to happen. You won't be able to hear the guitar, so fuck it anyway. I'd just like to tell you that I'm a very good person. I'm very good to my mum and I'm very good to my wife. I don't go home very often. I'm 31 years of age and I'm 31 years of age and I've had four wives. One of them's been mine. I was very frightened the first time I ever had sex, because I was on my own. I was a very lucky young man. I was breastfed till I was 14. Quick impression, who's this? Don't push me, don't push me. Humpty Dumpty. Never mind his bloody guitar, I can't play it anyway. He tied this sodden thing up. I bet he's a drummer. I didn't mean that, you're a liar, Stuart, you did. I just want you to sing me a wee song, but you've got to listen to the words very, very carefully. John Gordon Tee has lady says, my honey and my lover, shall we go and have a hump, or shall we take our supper? She turned to him and kindly said the bonny lassie, my noble lord, as you please, but your supper is not ready. A was talking to a girl behind the bar there. I says to her, do you know the difference between making love and talking? She says, no. I says, well, hold on, I'll have a chat with you later on. My wife calls me Southern Comfort. And a lot of people ask why. She says, because I'm some kind of fancy liquor. But I don't really know what she means by that. Like, you know, myself, I'm a kind of backward person. But I would like to explain a little bit about Scottish history. And indeed, a little bit about English history. There was, years ago, a lot of men who were married and had families in their lives, and particularly daughters, wanted to see their daughters wed into a good family, a financially substantial family, somebody with a level head who would make something of themselves, which is not a bad thing. Every man wants that for his daughter. And I know I've got six of them. They're not all to the same woman, but I do have six of them. Wish this thing had stopped whistling me. Is the F? How does that happen?
Sorry. Ow, flip.
That's only because you're here. I was going to say fuck. Anyway, I'm only kidding. I wasn't there. But up where I come from, you know, the northeast coast, they don't have the same kind of facilities up there as they do down here. For instance, they don't have tractors and things like that, you know, because they're a little bit, what you would probably call backward down here. They don't have things like that. They do have the old ox pulling the plough. Only to find that this chap is ploughing his field one day. She told me to get off. Sounds just like my wife. Anyway, she's only jealous because I've got a dad. Anyway, don't hassle me, I've got the microphone. But up where I come from, as I was saying, they don't have tractors as they used to, like, you know, they have the old oxen plough. Somebody said they seen a car going through the village once, but nobody had a camera to take a photograph, so nobody can actually verify it, if you understand what I mean. But I believe the chap, because I know him. Now, up where I come from, this chap is ploughing a field with an old ox and this plough cutter. He's ploughing the field, and the cutter of the plough gets broken on a stone. And he says, what the hell am I going to do? This field needs to be ploughed in order for my crop to be ready for a market day. He says, I know what I'll do. He says, I'll look over at McLeod's farm and ask if I can borrow his plough. And he gets over the first field and he says, I wonder if McLeod will lend me his plough. And he gets over the second field and he says, I don't think he will, we're not speaking. And he gets over the third field and he says, I'm absolutely positive McLeod won't lend me his plough. And he gets to McLeod's farm and he goes, McLeod says, yes, what do you want? He says, stick your sodden plough up your ass. I don't know why I'm laughing, I've heard it before. But this boy sitting in the middle of Glasgow Green Park crying, 93 years of age crying. He's sitting there crying. And this bloke comes up to him and he says, what's the matter with you? 93 years of age and he's sitting there crying. He says, what's the matter with you? He says, I got married about 3 weeks ago. He says, to a wonderful woman. Always get carried away in this bit. He says, I got married. She's a beautiful cook. And she's lovely looking. And I made love to her 3 times a day. He says, what are you crying for? He says, I forgot where I live. Fortunately, he gave me the address. I said to my wife, I says, I want to buy you something special for your Christmas. What would you like? She said, well, I'd like something that you won't waste your money on. Will you buy me a swimsuit? So I did. I bought her a swimsuit. I bought her a three-piece bikini. You might laugh, but I watched these fashion shows. It was two band-aids and a cork. And I got in a lot of trouble because I bought the wrong size cork. No, what I was saying earlier on was young chaps who'd had daughters wanted their daughters to marry into well-to-do families. As I said, it wasn't a bad thing. They just wanted them to do that. Now let me tell you a little story in music. what happened to somebody who wanted their daughter to marry into a well-to-do family. Just listen, please. The trees are ivy and the leaves, they are green. It's been many a long year since I he has long, long grown. Oh, father, dear father, you have done me muckle harm. For you have weighed me to hell that's our young. For he is but 16, and I am 21, and your laddie will be long, long a-growing. Oh, daughter, dear daughter, I hate him ye. Says, I'll pay. And we read in the paper next day, Jewish ventriloquist found dead in back alley. Little Jewish, this boy had been a rabbi all his life, and he'd done all the operations necessary for the wee boys that was come in. He cut off their foreskins, could never count, and one day this chap come in, and he cut off his foreskin, and he noticed they had no eyelids. So he made a set of eyelids out of the foreskins, and the poor boy ended up cockeyed. Not a shame. And he used to save these foreskins for a rainy day, so to speak. You know, a Jewish rainy day.
That's why the Jewish boys have all got big ears and bald heads. How much, man? Life! That's by the way, anyway. He saved these foreskins and he used to sew them together and make handbags. And women used to come around and buy these handbags, and he used to charge £400 a time for a handbag. And one woman says, that's a hell of a price for a handbag, isn't it? And the boy says, throw it twice, it becomes a suitcase. I'm going to put this, somebody's just got it. Must be the first time. Anyway, I'm just going to put the pipes down, put the microphone down rather, and give a couple of tunes on the pipes. And bugger everything up. Bill Fraser, you're a bastard. Bill Ferguson, you're a bastard.
just about to say, don't get away.
Glasgow Pipe Band,
who
will now give you a little bit of traditional stuff and a little bit of something else. I think there's a little bit of competition between them and Dysart tonight. I think tomorrow will be a bigger competition as well. The city of Glasgow is still tuning up, so if you all want to go to the bar, get yourself a drink, and then come back down, you've got about 10 minutes before they arrive. I didn't know about this one. This is unexpected, this is. I just put the microphone on the stand.
Why the
you very much. We've now got a young lad from the City of Glasgow Pipe Band who won the pre-brock today. And he's now just come on to give it a solo of pre-brock piping. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we've now got the City of Glasgow Pipe Band coming in to do the second part of this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, City of Glasgow, Pipe Major Hugh McCanns.
We must finish.
Thank you.
Thank you, Hugh, and the lads from the City of Glasgow. We have now got Dysart and Dundonald coming back on to give their final performance. And Bob Shepherd's just run down the field to fetch them up. Ladies and gentlemen, Dysart and Dundonald on the pipe meter, George Shepherd. Thank you.
downfall is.
Thank you.
City of Glasgow. Thank you very much indeed. Dysart of the Dundonald. Sorry, George. I'm sorry. Sorry, George. Well done, Dysart. Thank you very much indeed. Well done. Right, but the evening is not finished. We have now got the lad who won the drumming solos today, Sandy, from the city of Glasgow, who's now going to come on and do a drum solo. And we've got one or two of the lads who won the pre-brock, the March Strathspeyan Reel, who are going to give you a little bit of entertainment while you sit and have a pint or two. Ladies and gentlemen, Sandy from the city of Glasgow, who won the solo drumming today. Thank you.
Sunday, sitting in Glasgow. The next drummer we've got coming on, before the piping solos come on, is a 1987 World Soul Juvenile drummer. I think his leading tipper is trying to fetch him from the back of the bar. He should be here in about 2 seconds. In fact, he is now here. Right, George just enjoyed his trip on the way in. Okay, George Walls, 1987 World Juvenile Solo Champion. Thank you. Something on the pipes. The lad today who won the solo piping from Dysart Dundonald, young Dougie. Come on, Dougie, let's have you.
Dougie! Dougie! Encore! Encore, Dougie! Encore! Go on! Go on! Just a wee one before you go. Just a wee one. His pipe major says he's done well since he put his grace notes in. Tonight we've had the lads from Dysart, which is Scotland. We've had the lads from the city of Glasgow, which is Scotland. But we have not had a band from England. Right. Our junior solo drumming, which is tonight from the city of Salford, which is Manchester, is now going to give us a little tune. The lad from the city of Salford, thank you. Thank you.
That was a drumming bit, over. Do you mind if it goes a few minutes late? Do you mind? Right. We've got two pipers coming on. One piper today won the Mark Strasker in Real. The other piper won the Pre-Brock. We've got Davey and Alan, who are going to play together first of all. They're going to play individually, and they're going to play together again. And I think, oh, they're here. Last time I seen them, we were tuning up. All right. The two lads are here, David and Alan, who both won today the Pre-Brock and the Mark Strasser in Real. Thank you. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the end of this evening. Of all the piping, drumming, solos, etc. I would like you all to put your hands together for the City of Glasgow and the Dysart and Dundonald who give the concert. Thank you very much indeed. The bar will be open until so-and-so time. Thank you very much indeed for attending. Thank you for all our visitors from Scotland, Northern Ireland, England. Thank you very much indeed. Good night.
See you tomorrow, yeah.